Valley just won its first PIAA state championship. And we're coming from you live. From the very place, Central Valley High School in Pennsylvania. We are here to show you the four best segments that Reach and Teach history will ever see. We got one about a kid who went missing at this very high school. We got another one cooking it up, and you know, some sweet cookies with an ex-NFL coach. Next, we watching some really trendy TikToks like Charlie D'Amelio and the Renegade. And then we get to test the cafeteria food versus famous popular food joints. Stay tuned.
Hello and welcome to a special segment cooking with Coach with wide receivers coach, Coach Dias Central Valley, and wide receiver Chris Bullock. Let's see the contestants talk a little bit about each other. Coach Dias, what do you do?
I am the wide receiver coach for the Central Valley football team. I am a veteran football coach who has been coaching in the United States for probably 30 some years.
Chris, tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm a 6-foot wide receiver for Central Valley. I'm number 26. And I love to have fun and play football.
Very simple. We'll each have a 15-minute timer to decorate 6 cookies. They'll each have a boot, a wreath, a snowman, a snowflake, a gingerbread man, and a mitten. And the best batch wins based on creativity, neatness, and does the cookies look appealing?
The judges are Frank, myself, and we have a mystery judge that will be revealed later in the show. Time to start the competition. 3, 2, 1, go.
All right, Chris, how are your cookies coming along?
They're coming out right. They're coming out amazing. Business is booming.
Chris, hi, how are your cookies coming?
My cookies are coming pretty good. You know, I'm trying to get a little bit of design going here.
Got a theme for the cookies.
So, me and my mom, we usually watch Christmas movies and we make cookies and stuff. So I'm just trying to get the ones the Wonderland feeling in there. So
your idea about your cookies?
Well, I'm trying to go simple right here. I don't want it too complicated. I don't want it too confusing. I just want it very, very simple.
Theme for the cookies.
So me and my mom, we usually watch Christmas movies and we make cookies and stuff. So I'm just trying to get the ones the Wonderland feeling in there. So, you know, the viewers feel, you know, more.
Is she working? Because I ain't going to tell you nothing.
I got the house to yourself.
Yep.
So what's that mean?
I might invite a couple girls over.
Chris, it's the halfway point.
Oh, my God, man. We going pretty good. We looking solid.
Yes, sir.
It's the halfway point.
All right, it's the halfway point. And right now, I think I'm at halftime. I'm calling the timeout. I think that everything is starting to bounce off the tray, and we're moving forward. We're looking for a great second half.
We're getting down to the point. 5 minutes left.
How are you looking? I'm looking pretty good. 5 minutes, man. I'm just putting the finishing touches on it, and I think we're going to be in pretty good shape right here.
5 minutes left. How are you looking so far?
You looking Gucci. We looking swaggy. We looking good. We looking great. You know, I feel good about my
Chris, there's 2 minutes left. How's it coming?
It's coming cool, man.
This left, I think I'm doing pretty good over here. I'm looking at Chris's, and he's talking all this smack and talking about what he's doing. His is looking pretty sloppy, if you ask me. I'm not trying to be biased by any of the judges, but it's looking pretty sloppy.
Mark, do you talk?
Coach Todd, describe your cookies.
Okay, what I'm trying to present here is a creativity tray. Here you have a star, okay, with pretty bright structures on it. Here you have a little ginger man, okay, and he has 4 stars on his chest. So what I'm trying to do here is create creativity. My cookies are turning into objects and I want them to jump off the tray.
Chris, describe your cookies.
So what I want here, you know, I love sugar. I love me sugar. So it's Christmas time too, so I mean, a nice little swaggy figure, nice little swaggy character, and I got the star, because, you know, I'm the star of the show.
Real good.
Coach Tosh Trey, I like the creativity, I like the sprinkles, I like how he uses icing to spread it all around the cookie.
Well, for Chris's tray, I like all the sprinkles and all the icing, and this one right here is very colorful.
For Chris's tray, as what Frank said, I like how he uses the sprinkles And the one that really stands out to me is the stocking. It really looks like a real life Christmas stocking.
For Coach Ty's tray, as what Jack said, I like all the colors and all the creativity in it.
I really like this.
This is pretty good.
A lot of icing. I like the taste though.
And my winner is Chris, because his icing gave it a lot more taste and texture to the cookie.
My winner was Coach Ty, because his were a lot neater, a lot more colorful, and they were a lot more creative.
Frank, it looks like we need a third judge to decide this contest.
Well, here one comes.
What we got here?
We got some nice cookies out here.
Yeah, we do. Christmas cookies. I like them. Oh, you talk about sweetness. There's a lot of sugar on here. Well, that'll keep me going for the day. I like the colorful blue here. Make you very cheerful, happy, you know, get things done. But here, I have to say, very neat on the job. Over here, a lot of sweetness, a little sloppiness, though.
I'd have to say the winner of this right now, for the time and the effort, to go with Chris.
That's the conclusion of the competition today. I would like to thank these two contestants for battling it out to see who makes the better Christmas cookies. And I'd like to thank all of you watching this show as well. Thank you.
Man, those cookies look pretty good. That ex-NFL coach had a great design on his cookies. Let's see who can take home the win in this next challenge, where we will see if the students here at this school can tell the difference between cafeteria food and regular food from a Chick-fil-A place.
What's up? My name is Alex, and today we're going to be testing to see if our students can tell the difference between a school-bought lunch and a regular fast food meal. We'll be blindfolding our contestants and having them try both of the foods and try to guess which one is which.
First contestant is Simon. You are going to have him try chicken and see if he can tell the difference between the school lunch and the Chick-fil-A.
It's like plastic.
Yes. Which one do you think was the school lunch or the other lunch?
This one took me a thought. This is the school lunch on my left side. Chick-fil-A on my right side, easily.
All right, take off your blindfold.
Oh, I was right.
What's your opinions on each one?
All right, so I'm gonna start with the good first. Chick-fil-A. I've never had chicken tenders, actually, believe it or not. But these were super good. I really enjoyed them. It was really just amazing overall. Crispy on the outside, tender on the inside. Can't get better than that. Now, the school lunch, it wasn't a chicken. I'm gonna tell you, it was cold. It tastes like plastic.
What thou rating?
All right, so, Chick-fil-A, I'm gonna have to give it a nice 8 out of 10. I can't give it any higher because Chick-fil-A, as you guys all know, known for those amazing chicken sandwiches, right? Now, school lunch, 0.5 max, as high as I can go. Just because it's meat, that's the only reason why it's not a zero.
Nice, it's in front of you.
Which one do you think is the school lunch, and which one do you think is Chick-fil-A?
I think the left is the school lunch, and the right is my boy Chick-fil-A.
All right, take off your blindfold.
Wow!
So what's your opinion on these fries that you just tasted?
Well, Chick-fil-A, overall, so much better. Waffle fry, amazing. School lunch, I had hopes for it. 10 out of 10, 2 out of 10.
There's your cup. This one?
Yeah. All right, there it is. Okay, Joey. So, which one do you think was which?
I believe the first one I drank was the Bruntons.
Which one would that
be? And the second one was a school.
Alright, take off your blindfold.
And I was right.
Okay, Joey, so what's your opinions on these milks?
The Bruntons chocolate milk was thicker, and it was a lot more tasteful than the school chocolate milk. The school chocolate milk was a lot thinner and did not taste as good.
Okay, Jay, so give me your ratings on these.
The Bruntons chocolate milk, 7 out of 10. The school chocolate milk, 3 out of 10.
Wow, that taste test was hilarious. It seems like the contestants had a great time trying out great food from the cafeteria and popular food joints around the world. Now, it seems like something that would do well on the TikTok app. Speaking of TikTok, here's what's trending around the world, like number 26, the state champion wide receiver. Here you go, Alex.
What is TikTok? It is a Chinese-run social media app with an interesting setup that finds your interests through the users you follow, sounds you listen to, and hashtags you like to create a custom For You page for you. This For You page is the center of the platform. Here, any video can go viral. This app reminds a lot of people about the old social media app, Vine. As the videos on TikTok are short, usually funny, we did a poll around the school and found how often students use TikTok and what their favorite trends are.
We had two questions. One was, how often do you use TikTok? The second one was, what are your favorite topics on TikTok? We had 7 people we surveyed. 3 of them said that they use TikTok very often. The other 3, or other 4, said that they use TikTok a lot. For the second question, 2 of them said that they like watching dances. Two of them said they liked home improvement.
Hi everybody, this is the story of the time that I decided to change my shed into a she shed with my little sister. So we started by drilling in all the panels on the side because they were really loose and flappy. And then we went ahead and painted it gray. And then we did all the detailing in this silver white color. Overall, it looked really good.
And the other 3 said they like cooking.
1 cup of brown sugar, 1 cup of peanut butter, 1 large egg, 1 teaspoon of baking soda, 1/2 a cup of chocolate chips. Mix it all together. Divide into 12 and place on a prepared baking sheet at 350 for 8 to 10 minutes.
That is all for my segment. Thank you.
Okay, so from that poll, we learned what some students like to watch on TikTok. But what do they like to post? Let's find out.
I'm literally about to throw up. There's the stankiest leg outside.
Wow.
I feel pretty sorry for the next guy who looks at me funny.
What about that guy?
I wear this on Monday, wear this on Tuesday, wear this on Wednesday, wear this on Thursday, wear this on Friday.
So as you can see, Danica posts a lot of funny videos, and she also posts fashion videos, which I really like. She's really entertaining, and she has a lot of charisma when she makes her TikToks.
Not ugly, I'm just ugly.
Back for me when
when I die, girl, I'm coming back for you. And I'ma pull up in an all black Benz.
Pull up in an all black Benz. Diamonds on my wrist. Shawty scream my name and you can't miss what you never had. Hey, hey,
I'm the juice. Coding got me tripping.
So as you can see, Amanda makes a lot of funny videos, and she even has 64,000 likes on one of her posts.
Fishing pole, grill it in.
Work,
hold on. It's me and my friends.
Go, bud.
Work, you know what I'm saying? Walk in, walk out, let's go.
Yeah.
Hey, walk it out, walk it out.
Yeah. Work, yeah.
Cha-cha, cha-cha.
Work, yeah.
So as you can see, Brooke does a lot of TikTok dancing. She's really funny when she does these dances though, and she has a lot of school spirit. I would just like to say thank you to Amanda, Danica, and Brooke for being in this video, and we hope you guys enjoyed. This was Trending.
Do you guys think that 2020 could get any worse? Well, I heard that at this very school, Central Valley High School, that a student has gone missing. I think it calls for some legitimate investigation. Let's see what went wrong in Campus Unsolved.
The news. At 9 a.m. Eastern Time, a kid from Central Valley High School went missing. If you see this kid, call 724-775-4300. Kid went missing. Come on, pick up. Billy, there's a kid that just went missing at Central Valley High School. You guys should probably check this out.
No way, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll see you.
Get on it.
Go check it out, bro.
Before the merger, and have been principal here since the beginning, which would have been the 2010 school year.
Mm. Have you heard of any ghost stories?
I have not heard of any ghost stories here at the school, no.
Mm. Have you experienced like any weird activities?
Here at the school?
Yeah.
No, I would not say that I have, no.
Like, you know how like the clock or anything like go off?
Yeah, there have been things that have happened, like the alarms, some old fire alarms that we don't use anymore have gone off at times. If you're here when no one else is here, the building makes some noises.
Yeah.
You know, different creaks and cracks and so on, yes.
You ever, like, think that it could be, like, something like a ghost?
I have not thought it could be a ghost. I just think it's the noises that these old buildings make, especially when it's cold outside and so on.
Do you believe in ghosts?
I don't know that I believe in ghosts, but I believe in a second life when you leave here, yes.
I'll tell you when I've been grabbed.
Really?
Yeah. Right. Old house. My old house.
Yeah. How long have you been in the janitor?
2 years.
2 years?
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever, like, heard or seen any ghost stories here? Like
here in the school?
Yeah.
I've heard.
You heard?
They might see somebody in the hallway, like a shadow.
Really?
Heard more heard noises. Mm-hmm.
All right. Have you ever experienced any like paranormal activities in the school?
Nah, I can't. Well, I can say I heard radios playing in the garage one night when I walked over though.
Really? And there's no one there?
No, just the trucks were parked up. I was the only one in the school.
Wow. Have you ever tried to stop the activity?
No.
What was the scariest thing that has happened to you at the school?
Nothing really. No, I can't say I've been scared or anything.
Do you believe in ghosts?
Sure.
Sure?
Mm-hmm.
What was the latest time you stayed here after?
Latest time for me was, let me think. I want to say it was like 11:30, 12:00 maybe. It's been a while.
Thank you.
Sure thing.
It's very cool to see our own students here at Central Valley are posting on TikTok. Some of these are even trending. From the scary story to the ex-NFL coach making Christmas cookies, this is our Central Valley broadcast. We had a lot of fun doing this, and it's not over yet. We need your guys' help to share it with your friends and family through December 11th and December 30th, because the school with the most views wins $1,000. We are the only school in Beaver County competing. Let's show them how strong Beaver County is. Thank you so much for watching and help us out. Happy holidays, everybody.
Hey, remember to share and share, share, share. Share 26 times with 26 friends.